So yes, this talk is more about using some parsing techniques to extend the capabilities of editors. So my talk is about virtual textual model composition for supporting versioning and aspect orientation. So the question is, why do you need it? So in many projects, people have different documents which need to be maintained. For example, they might have different languages. Here, they might not need to maintain only a single version of the document, but multiple versions. For example, you might need to support 3 or 4 major releases of your artifact when you want to fix a bug. Or you might have different customers where we choose different features of your artifact, and so you have different variants of your artifact. So this is a common problem, and it has been solved for many specific areas. Maybe the most common one is software product lines or aspect orientation for programming languages. But of course, these maintenance activities could also be required for other domain-specific languages. So the question we asked ourselves is, how can we provide such maintenance support, such as product line engineering or aspect orientation, for different kinds of domain-specific languages without great effort? Because many domain-specific languages are used by only a few people, and any effort required would probably not be done. So we developed basically a tool which we call Virtual Edit, and which is a framework to provide multi-version editing, so you can edit multiple versions of the same document at the same time, and aspect orientation for many different languages. In particular, all languages which are using the Xtext framework. The Xtext framework is a language generation framework where you can specify your language, and it automatically generates not only a parser, but also an editor with auto-completion, syntax highlighting, and so on. And our approach retains all these properties of the Xtext editor, but adds this maintenance support. And yes, and it's built on model virtualization to be able to build easily a union of multiple documents. So currently, if you have a text-based artifact, you might need to do the maintenance activity, and you might use usual versioning tools for that. For example, JIT or other comparison tools. However, they either do not provide a unified view. So as you can see in the screenshot, you have two windows where you see the two documents separated, and not a single document. And so you also cannot edit both at the same time, or they do provide a unified view. So for example, you have a simple merged view where you can see which lines have been added or removed, but then you cannot edit it anymore. Also, they only typically compare 2 or 3 files, depending on how you count, and not a large amount of files. On the other hand, the virtual edit tool, as you can see in this right screenshot, provides a unified view of as many documents as your system can handle, and it still allows you to edit this unified document. If you edit a part which is common to all models, which has no background, then the change will be applied to all of your base models. If you, however, edit a part which only occurs in a single model, as its background has the color of this model, then this change will only be done in this document where the part occurs. On the bottom, you see a selection window where you can select which models you want to display. And if you unselect or select some model, the text window will be updated automatically. Yes, and I have already said that there are colored parts for elements which occur only in a single model. And it's gray if there are multiple models involved, but not all. So just for the architecture of a virtual edit, at first we need to know which files we want to show. So this is not a great problem, but we have either a file where you can specify which files you want to merge, or we use a file name convention to load the files. Then the files are loaded, these are standard modeling files, are loaded into a virtual model in our format. This virtual model has a property that the union can be built easily, so we build the union of that. And this is the union, but in our format, so we need to basically translate it back to get the format xText also uses. But of course, you cannot just transform it, but we need to have a virtual E object which uses our virtual objects so that changes which are done are actually propagated back correctly. And then we use this xText framework, which uses the same kinds of E objects, but unfortunately, when you update your document, it reparses the document, and so old objects are lost, the new are created, so we need to do some synchronization to get them in sync. This is different for example, approaches which are used for graphical editors, because in graphical editors, you typically may have some syntax-directed editing, so all of your model is directly displayed in your graphical editor, while as text-based editors are typically well, parsing-oriented. I mean, they also can be syntax-directed, but the xText is not. So for our virtual model, the main requirements, as I've already said, is that you can easily compose them. This means that you can easily add and remove models from your composition. So we wanted that our models build a group with model addition. So we can add them and remove them and build the inverse and so on. Also, we do want to avoid when the models are unified, that conflicts occur and are displayed. Because of course, it would annoy the user if before editing the document, he or she would need to resolve some conflicts. Also, we don't want an automatic conflict resolving, which changes the base model, because we don't want that just because the user views the files, the base model gets suddenly changed. So we define our modeling structure as follows. We have some identifiers, which defines which objects can exist. We have an existence set, which defines which objects do exist. We have a class assignment, which specifies which objects have which classes, usually one leaf class only. And we have some attribute values and some reference link for each of the objects. And we assume an equa or UML-like meta model with classes, attributes, references, and so on. So just an example. We might have a single file, a single version of a file, a class with just two methods. And as another version of this document might have added a method in between the first and the second method. So if we want to have the existence set for both, we see that in the first existence set, the classes and the two methods are contained, while in the second document, all three methods are contained. If we cannot, we want that if we build the union of our models and subtract one of the model, we get the other one. So of course, we cannot use the normal union, because then if we, for example, would build the union of the existing set and then remove the second model, then we would just get the empty model. So we need to have a multiset, and this multiset must allow not only natural numbers, but integer numbers, because we want to build the inverse. So if we do that, then everything works correctly, then the union of both models contains the two methods and the class twice and the new method only once, and we can subtract and add as just as we want. For lists, this gets a bit more complicated, because we need to add and remove lists from each other. I won't go into the details here. They are not complicated, but just for time issues. Basically, there are two requirements. At first, you want to add lists from each other, so you want to have a list and another list and build the addition, and this addition must form a group. So of course, it's not append one list to the other, but build the union, basically, of two lists where if two lists are equal, the same list should result. Thus, we do not map, also the typical list structure could just associate a value to each integer index, but we do not use a single value, but a set of values. And also, we want that if you add something or remove something, we do not want that all of our list indexes change as a result. So we need a special index structure. So this is for the definition of the virtual model. And as you have seen, building a union of two models does not result in any conflicts, because you can just add things. So of course, the conflicts do not disappear suddenly. But the merge conflicts, which are usually there, are just constraint violations in our virtual model. So for example, in this virtual model, you might suddenly have an attribute of an object which doesn't exist anymore. Or you have two values for some list index. But these are just constraint violations. And of course, if we want to go back to a model, we have to handle them. And we handle them in our compatibility layer. So when we transform our virtual model to e-objects, we solve them. This compatibility layer just builds dynamic updatable e-objects. And the update strategy, if you edit them, is different for multi-versioning and aspect orientation. Whereas for multi-versioning, we just edit all base models. Whereas for aspect orientation, we just edit the base model or the aspect application relevant. And the conflicts are implicitly resolved. Basically, if we do two conflicting updates, we just pick some arbitrary value. If we have a single valued attribute, if we have a multi-valued attribute, we just display both values. And if we delete an object, in principle, we would delete all references or also new references. But in practice, so that the text change is not too large, we let the new link stay. So for the multi-versioning, everything has been explained now, but not for the aspect orientation part. And we see aspect application as transformation application. And it works as follows. We start with our input model. And then we do not want that our aspect application actually changes the input model, because we want to be able to easily revert it. So we do a virtual composition of our input model and some additional delta model, which is changed. The result is this output model. And if we transform our output model, the transformation edits are only applied to our delta model, so the input doesn't change. Then we have an additional model, because the user might change some parts of the model which only exist because the aspect has been executed, and these are also stored in an additional model. And if you re-execute the aspect, you can just clear the delta model associated to the aspect and rerun the transformation. So we have implemented some aspect G-like language and some Java-like language specifically to try out whether our generic virtual model can be used for that. But and this is specific for these languages, so it cannot be generalized. But we support engine rules to define general aspects. In fact, however, you could also use these engine rules to just perform refactoring, and then our approach works as preview refactoring operations for any kind of models and any kind of domain-specific languages. Yes, the editor just looks like the multi-version editor, okay, except that instead of having multiple models with which you can select or unselect, you deselect or select aspect applications. We have evaluated our approach. We wanted to know, is virtual edit able to support this multi-versioning and aspect orientation on the one hand, and on the other hand, also if it's actually applicable to languages. So We selected the 5 most popular X6 languages from GitHub and tried to apply our approach on. First, the research question is whether we can perform multi-versioning in aspect orientation scenarios. The answer is basically for multi-versioning, it works by construction, whereas we had to implement some SVG-like language for the other part, and we found out that at least basic features of SVG are implementable with reasonable effort, and this effort is increased by the fact that currently we do not support code generation, so people have to use reflection all of the time, but this could be easily implemented. For the second research question, we have tried to just generate the default X6 editor from the X6 languages and then just replace the default X6 editor with our X6 editor and see how it works. And we found out that 2 languages worked well. One language had the strange problem that all formatting was lost when we applied our approach. And this is because in general, when you load some document of that language and just reserialize it back, the formatting is lost. So actually, that isn't even related to our approach, but it is that way. And for 2 languages, we could not really try it out because the way we did this evaluation is we just used the default generated editor, and this language had some more complex dependencies, so they could not be used. So to sum it up, we have developed some framework, some virtual model composition framework, which works for X6-based languages. We have developed a model formalism, which allows to easily add and remove models from each other. We have implemented multi-versioning, where you can view and edit multiple artifacts at the same time. We have implemented aspect orientation, where you can dynamically show and hide aspect applications and still edit the base model. Also, you can use it to display refactorings. This approach has been implemented and passed the artifact evaluation. And you can download both the source code and a virtual machine, which contains basically just a tool to try it out. Under this address, virtual edit big.wien.crt. But of course, the work is not done here. It's because at first, we currently need a file where we store which versions we want to compare. And of course, it would be nicer to just extract this information from Git repositories because it's there. We want to improve the speed using incremental evaluation. We currently only support imperative transformations, but we want to allow functional transformations. We want to show conflicts so that users can resolve them with some user interface, and we want to perform model integration. Yes, that's for my talk. Thank you for your attention. And if you have any questions, you can ask me now or somehow later this week.